Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the home of Super Bowl 50, Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Arizona Cardinals and the San Francisco 49ers. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. The first carry now. This is Johnson. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
The evaluation process in today's NFL does not take into account as much bulk as it does speed. And that's what we're seeing with the linebacker position. Those guys that can run, they can play at any spot because they can make plays on the opposite side of the line of scrimmage.
Let's go. Let's go. Blue 58.
On second down, Johnson. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. Give him 2 yards that time, and it's going to leave him with a third and 11 situation.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Here we go. 1-18.
On third down, Palmer. He's got time. Trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Jimmy Ward. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. The 49er offense now making their way out onto the field. So following the interception, here's Gabbert. And incomplete to open things up. He was looking for Quentin Patton that time. And now it's second down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Second down following the incompletion. On second down, Gabbert again. It's hauled in by Torrey Smith. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. 15 yards through the air and a first down. First carry for Carlos Hyde. And he's going to push his way down to about the 12. For Hyde, his last go-around against Dallas, 15 carries, 74 yards, and a touchdown.
And I think what they really want from Carlos Hyde is to be in a position in the fourth quarter where he can be a closer. Because my experience with him coming out of college, the more carries, the better. And he's always finished strong, but they have to be in that position where they can feed him the ball in the fourth quarter.
Again, it's Hyde. And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Not enough there for a first. No gain, as a matter of fact. And it leaves them at third and one.
Well, after what we just saw, we know that with third down coming up, this is not a gimme for the offense. They've got to figure out what they want to do. Do they challenge their offensive line and try and run it? Or do they go ahead and concede that this is a tough defense and put it in the air?
They'll run it. Here's Hyde. And he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. They'll be marked inches short. No gain on the play. And that's going to lead them to fourth down.
On every snap, a defense is trying to establish who they are. But on third and short, that's really when you put it out there and tell people who you are. And that's exactly what they did. For the offense, they're looking at their offensive line and saying, guys, where are you? We need you on those plays.
And Dawson's kick is good. And the 49ers take a 3-0 lead. And the first 3 points of the night belong to our home team as they get the field goal on the game's initial drive.
A good, solid drive. It didn't wind up in the end zone, but that's okay. You've got something positive on the board, and you got the early lead.
The punter, Pinion, now to kick this one away. J.J. Nelson now to return. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. And the Cardinals offense here ready to take over. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Jaron Brown, the intended target. That'll bring up second down. And on second and 10 now. They come out here in the eye. And Palmer gives to Johnson. And some space here. And he's going to be out of bounds up around the 45-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
That outside handoff to the left, that play has to warm the heart of an offensive line coach, because they controlled the left side where they were supposed to, but they didn't allow anything to leak from the backside on the right side of the offensive line either. Well played.
Yeah, and it created a big run.
Here we go. Blue 58.
They go play action here on first down. Deep drop. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
Here we go. Blue 95. Blue 95.
They'll let him now out of the gun. Oh, what a move. And he'll fight his way forward to about the 48-yard line. Calling a gain of 4, and it'll leave him with a third down and 6 to go.
Have you talked with your friends who are in the fantasy leagues? I keep hearing David Johnson's name is coming up in a big way.
Boy, he was a steal, third rounder out of Northern Iowa, and I think last year started as a fourth string back, didn't he?
He certainly did, but boy, he produces the year one out. Remember, can run it. He can catch it. He was a wide receiver at Northern Iowa before he became a running back, and also has great kick return ability. Ran one back for a touchdown in 2015.
Ready to go now in the second quarter. Brandon Gaughton, Charles Davis. It's the Cardinals in possession of the football, and they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10.
Here we go. 258.
On first and 10, it's Palmer. He gets it into the hands of Larry Fitzgerald. 11 yards on the pickup, and it's good enough for an Arizona first.
Anytime you call man coverage against Larry Fitzgerald, you're really holding your breath as a defensive guy, because his ability to run such precise routes and use that big frame that he has, that body against you, it's going to be very difficult to break passes up against it.
Yeah, when you make 9 Pro Bowls in your first 12 years, you might want to give him a little bit more coverage than that.
Yeah, it's not just athletic ability. He's a thinking man's receiver as well.
Tackle made by Antoine Bethea.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front, because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Again, it's Johnson. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 3.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback, because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
An extra DB for the 49ers now on 3rd. Here's Palmer, and able to find John Brown. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defense side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. They're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues downfield.
From the red zone now, here's Palmer on first down. Can't find anyone open. They were trying to get it there to Chris Johnson, the running back. And that'll bring up second down.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense.
Get ready. Blue 58.
Second and 10. It's Palmer again. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. The tight end, Jermaine Gresham, the intended receiver. And that takes us from second to third down. So a second down in completion now brings up third down.
Let's go, let's go. Why? 18.
On third down, Palmer. And he's got Fitzgerald. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
Well, the advantage has certainly shifted to the defense as we began that third down play, and they found a way to foil it and pick up a first down.
Third time's a charm, right? Two incompletions. Had to have it on third, and they got it.
Yeah, they stuck with it, weren't daunted at all, and picked it up.
All right now, blue 58. Blue 58.
First and goal from the five. They'll try and run. This is Johnson. And he fights his way in, not giving up. And it's a Cardinal touchdown. David Johnson taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Cardinals have retaken the lead.
Well, we got a little bit of everything on that run. Offensive line creating some space. But how about the guy running behind his pads into the end zone?
What does that mean when a guy says running behind his pad? It
means that he's going to be a physical runner. That way he's able to use his shoulder pads, his forearms, anything to ward off people to power his way forward.
Now Catanzaro after the touchdown to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. And now the 49er offense ready to go and getting back out onto the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Here's Hyde as they begin on the ground. And he'll take this one up close to the 25-yard line. And a big face mask penalty here, 15 yards.
You never want to get your hands up in the face mask area because your fingers can get tangled up there, and that can hurt you as a player.
Tied, muscles him off, and he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Good job, man. Good job.
Second down, Hyde, and he'll get it down to the 47 here. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks. And they're going to speed things up here. Gabbard on first down, finding time, and that's incomplete. Carlos Hyde was the target, and that'll bring up second down. Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10.
Hey, we got four down.
They'll run it now out of the gun. as he's got this down inside the 40 to the 39. A nice job to get eight there after the incompletion, and now they'll look at a third and two coming up.
Carlos Hyde's a physical, tough runner. Had a few dings, but I don't think he should change a thing in terms of style. And I think that playing in Chip Kelly's offense gives him a chance to catch the ball more as well.
He can do both with him, Kenny, and he said he's excited to be in that Chip Kelly offense.
I think the versatility will really be to his liking.
Gabbert, he's got time in the pocket. A dump off for Davis. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. First down, Gabbert. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Vance McDonald, the tight end, was the target. And it's second down. So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. On second down, Gabbert again to the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet inbounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
Seventh play of the drive forthcoming on third and eight. On third down, Gabbert. And that is, I think he caught it. He did, but they'll say out of bounds. It'll be incomplete. A third down, he tried to stay in bounds, did all he could. He caught it, but was led a little bit too far.
Yeah, and that's always difficult, isn't it? Because you know half of your body is trying to stay behind while the other half is reaching out, trying to catch the football. The top half worked. It was the bottom half that was in question.
And the kick for the 41-year-old is up and good. And they'll get it back within a point at 7-6. A little bit of a lower trajectory there on the deep kick, and it worked.
Had to do it because he had to drive it out low because of the length of the kick. Able to do that, got it above the defense and over the post.
The punter Pinion now to kick this one away. This one fielded at the 5. Oh, a little 360.
Oh, man.
And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. And the Cardinals getting set to trot out there now. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
On first and 10, it's Palmer to the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were.
Can you do any more work or make it more dramatic for not much gain than what we just saw there? Did you see how his toes got down? Tip tap, got him down. But what'd he get out of it?
He sold the sizzle. He just had no steak.
I mean, was it 1 yard?
Yeah, you plays like that, you at least expect a first down. They're just 1 yard. On second down, Palmer surveying the field. And that's incomplete. That one was intended for John Brown. And it's third down. And defensively, it's a nickel formation here on third down and 9. From the gun on third down, it's Palmer. It's caught left side by John Brown. And now the 49ers signal for a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Now the punter Ryan Quigley is on in his fourth season out of Boston College. Back deep, Jeremy Curley. Yeah, he was looking for the checkup bounce, didn't get it. That scoots all the way into the end zone now for a touchback. The 49ers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time, do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it, they're down, they're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk is a big decision here.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So it'll be first down here after the run. On first and 10, Gabbard. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away. So not to get too overcritical there because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it and he gets those shoulders right, that pass will go from incomplete to complete.
A second down throw now for Gabbard. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward.
Third and five, so they bring in an extra defensive back.
Expecting pass. Gabbard from the gun on third down. And that's incomplete. Clock stops with 10 seconds left. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
So on fourth down, out comes Bradley Pinion to punt this one away. And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half. Why do anything else? Let's get out of there.
And with time running down, they go down to a knee. So a very tight first half. We had to break in a one-point game. As we send you across the country to Orlando, standing by there, Larry Ridley with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry, so both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. Returnable here for Davis. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Here comes the 49ers offensive unit as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. And room to run as he's up past the 35-yard line. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a second and one.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. They run it again with Hyde. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third. They tried to run the counter, just that the defense wasn't fooled.
And when they're not fooled, you see the end result. Because what you're doing there, you mentioned the counter. You're using your offensive linemen sometimes to pull or move to influence the defensive front to go in that direction and create the space back in the other side and block it appropriately. But you're exactly right. Didn't move him, sat there waiting for him and made the play.
Just a one-yard pickup there, and it'll be fourth down.
Third and two, and they ran the ball for only 1 yard, and everybody's going to scream at the offense. But let's give a lot of credit to the defense on that play. Defensive front out leveraged the offensive line. They got more people to the football. Yeah, they won that battle in a big way, and they're forcing a big decision now by the guys on offense.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And no one there to stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. A look at the offense now here, coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Now how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. And he'll be taken down right around the 27. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
They go to Johnson again. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set. Tenth carry for Johnson. And he's brought down. Give him 11 on the game there. And the Cards are going to have a first down.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. And he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers. And they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
Now a play fake here on first down. Caught on the left side, Fitzgerald. And he's brought down. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you can get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
One receiver right, that's Brown. Now Palmer, he's got Floyd out left. Call it a gain of 5, and that'll make it 2nd down.
But that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
On 2nd down, here's Palmer. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's 3rd. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Throwing again here, Palmer. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line.
Well, it wasn't a big strike, But that completion put them in really great range. What do we have now, 4th and inches?
Yeah, it's not more than a half a foot.
You know what I would do here?
You would always go for it.
I'm one of those guys.
Back now here in Santa Clara. This one's still anybody's ball game. It's a 1-point difference here as we begin the fourth quarter play. And Catanzaro's kick is right through, and they bump the lead up to 4 now at 10-6. So they get the 3 here, but you wonder whether that's going to be enough.
Yeah, I mean, you've now made it so they need a touchdown rather than a field goal to catch them. But you're right. If they'd gotten 6 out of that drive, this would be a much different game.
Now after the made field goal, Catanzaro to boot this one away on the kickoff. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. The San Francisco offense getting their last-minute instructions before they take over here. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They go play action here on first down. He's got time. And he's not able to get away. Gabbert sacked. Frosty Rucker in there to sack him for a loss of 6. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
Throwing. Gabbert. Smith catches left side. It'll be a pickup of 12 yards. And they're going to face a 3rd down. So here we go, a 3rd down after the 2nd down pass completion.
Black 22! Black 22!
From the shotgun, it's Gabbert. And this is going to be incomplete.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this 3rd down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
Here's Bradley Pinion now as he's on to punt for San Francisco. Ellington now to return it. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And the Cards will take over 1st and 10. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for 3, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get free, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively.
Let's go, let's go. 1-18. 1-18.
2nd and 10. It's Palmer again. And Gresham has it left side. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. And that's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
A 1st down carry here for Johnson. And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47. A good run there on 1st down, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 2. Well, they'll take that every time with a lead, first down, fourth quarter, getting 8 yards. You love that.
They will take it, and you have to ask the defensive guys, why did you give it? I mean, you know the situation. You're down, have to stop them, have to get the football back. But 8 yards on first down puts them back on their heels.
Palmer gives to Johnson, and this carry not as productive. He's swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. Only a yard on the pickup, so from a good situation on second and two, it's now third and one. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Finding fouls complete. And he's brought down after a good game. Stopped here for no gain, and then it's going to take us to the 2-minute warning. And now the 49ers signal for a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Comes play number 6 on this drive. Johnson. And he'll lose you. And the 49ers going to take another timeout. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down.
Get ready. 1-18. 1-18.
They'll hand it off now. Johnson. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. It'll be from the right hash, and it'll be a 36-yarder. And Catanzaro's kick is right through, and that'll open the lead up to a touchdown now at 13-6. So, Charles, I think from a defensive perspective, you have to look at that field goal there and consider it a win.
You were able to keep them within a touchdown, so no question about it. That was the kind of stand that keeps you in ball games.
Now, after the made field goal, Catanzaro to boot this one away on the kickoff. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. They get him that time thanks to the safety blitz as he sank for a loss of four. They'll look to throw. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Back to throw. And nearly intercepted there. That would have been ball game if he had clinched it and caught it. Instead, it gives him one more chance here on fourth down.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
Desperation time. Gabbert on fourth. He shakes him off. And he'll maybe get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And that's going to be just about all she wrote for this one. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. They have the lead, obviously, late in the game. I guess the good news for them is if for some reason they would make a mistake, a field goal does the opposition no good.
Everyone loves to have a little bit of a cushion, and that helps you immeasurably. But the bottom line is, do all the things that you're taught in order to close out the game. Don't even let that become an issue.
Yeah, but still a one-possession game. This one not fully over yet. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Down to Amigos Palmer, and that should wrap this one up. A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you prime the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.